Good afternoon to you all. Aften Posten. VG. Vartland. Dagsavisen. Niti. Klassenkampen. TV2. NRK. Norway has a diverse and healthy media. A free and civil society must have diversity, balance, dialogue. Your media sometimes agrees with the government, and sometimes it disagrees strongly with them. This is healthy. Freedom of speech is the oxygen of a free society. Hugo Chavez was democratically elected president of my country in 1998. He presented himself to the world as a benevolent socialist leader, a heroic figure. In my experience, he is not a friend of human rights, of human dignity, or freedom of expression. I am the general manager of a television channel that is independent. I have worked in the media for more than 50 years. We criticize the government when we do not agree. We think it is healthy for a free society to have diversity of opinion, balance, dialogue, pluralism. Mr. Chavez is not a friend of anyone who disagrees with him. No, he turns them into enemies, and he plants the idea of hatred among his followers for all media who disagree. I do not wish to tell you that Mr. Chavez, what Mr. Chavez has said about the media. Let me show you, in his own words, what he has to say about my colleagues in the media, newspapers, private television stations, regardless of whether they are on the right or the left. This is a short video with images from Chavez. There are many videos on YouTube. You can access them anytime. You can find longer ones there. All of this is in context. All of this can be verified. Please, let's take a moment.
Pero seguimos enfrentando la campaña mediática. No nos importa. Los dueños de los medios, allá ellos con su conciencia.
Lo que hagan los dueños de los medios de comunicación. Que se metan sus medios de comunicación en el bolsillo. Que los agarren. Los enrollen bien enrollados y se los metan en el bolsillo.
Entonces hay que identificar los enemigos de la revolución.
Medios de comunicación antisocial. De degeneración social.
Vayan a decirle al pueblo que esos son los periódicos de la mentira. Eso hay que repetirlo por todas partes.
Y les vamos a inspeccionar hasta... No voy a decir qué palabra pensé. Bueno, les vamos a inspeccionar. Sí, no voy a decir la palabra que me llegó a la mente. No, ustedes saben cuál es. Les vamos a revisar hasta el techo de la boca.
Nadie tiene el derecho de estar lanzando todos los días veneno y más veneno a la mente de los venezolanos a través de la manipulación de algunos medios de comunicación social. Nadie tiene el derecho de hacerlo.
No vaya a ser que alguien, repito, vaya a ser víctima de la operación psicológica bestial que nos están dirigiendo a través de los grandes medios de comunicación social.
Los de los grandes medios de comunicación siguen utilizando periodistas tarifados y les pagan para que mientan y para que atropellen al pueblo venezolano.
Tengan cuidado con el periódico que compren, que algunos andan envenenados.
¿Cuál es la cámara de Globovisión ahí? Vamos. ¿Hay algún periodista aquí de Globovisión? Vamos a darle un saludo a la periodista. Pero a ellos los utilizan, ellos no pueden decirlo porque los votan.
Absolutamente nadie nos dice cómo hacer nuestro trabajo.
Medios de comunicación antisocial, lo voy a llamar desde hoy, lo prometo.
medios de comunicación antisocial. Siempre hay excepciones. Y sabemos cuáles son las excepciones. Estoy hablando de la regla.
Ese titular que sacó ese periódico, que se ha convertido, como todos los que maneja esa familia Capriles, en todo, y dicen que son los periódicos del pueblo, Última Noticia, El Mundo y toda esa línea de periódicos, vayan a decirle al pueblo que esos son los periódicos de la mentira. Eso hay que repetirlo por todas partes. De la mentira, de la manipulación.
Tengan cuidado con el periódico que compren, que algunos andan envenenados. Ojo pelado con la prensa. Vean bien, sepan y entiendan todos que hay periódicos que andan envenenados. Pero les meten veneno. En la noche hay un equipo de envenenadores envenenando periódicos. ¿Ah?
Si no, yo me veré obligado a activar mecanismos de defensa del interés nacional y de la verdad y del orden público.
Les tengo que recordar que ustedes lo que tienen es una concesión que yo pudiera en cualquier momento revocarla. Revocarla.
Por la manipulación del diario El Nacional y una campaña de mentiras inmoral, sin ningún límite, yo debo decirlo, lamento cómo se perdió esa cosecha.
Nosotros vamos a continuar atentos en este momento. Pues ha sido difícil la situación. Nosotros continuamos aquí, muy atentos, a la espera de la información y de la noticia.
Están atacándolo, están arremetiendo contra los medios de comunicación también. También lo hacen contra los medios de comunicación. Pueden ver que la agresión y la violencia es terrible en este lugar. Periodistas han sido agredidos, grupos de camarógrafos han sido agredidos. Estamos aquí, por supuesto, nosotros a riesgo, en el medio de estos...
Mauro está hospitalizado en una clínica con politraumatismo en el cráneo y en el abdomen.
Presidente de la República incitan a las agresiones hacia los periodistas.
Preferimos ir a un barrio donde pueda haber un tiroteo que ir a cubrir una cadena de presidentes.
Pues nos ofenden, nos empujan, nos gritan.
Pero la cuestión es que ustedes tienen que salir con chaleco de antibalas, según oí. Y eso es grave, eso es muy grave.
Los equipos reporteriles de Venevisión y Televen fueron agredidos salvajemente.
Por este camino al cual vamos, que es una cosa que el gobierno no controla a pesar de todas las medidas cautelares, pues puede suceder lo que ha sucedido en esos países, que empiecen a haber periodistas muertos.
Es obvio que es peligrosísimo.
Asimismo, planteó que el problema de la libertad de expresión en nuestro país tiene carácter internacional.
Invita a la autocensura, al amedrentamiento, a que los periodistas y los medios se sientan acosados y se sientan en peligro.
Obviamente, si sigue así, Venezuela va a caer en una dictadura.
Desde esta mañana están instalados en casi todas los canales de televisión privados. De manera cínica, de manera descarada, y todos esos temas tenemos que comenzar a discutirlos en serio. Yo, conversando en las últimas horas, en los últimos días, con el ciudadano presidente de la Asamblea Nacional, con el ciudadano presidente del Tribunal Supremo de Justicia, con el ciudadano presidente del Consejo Nacional Electoral, con el ciudadano defensor del pueblo. Aquí tenemos que empezar a apretar las tuercas. Yo he mandado a comprar un alicate porque voy a empezar a apretar tuercas.
Well, you've had the opportunity to listen to the Venezuelan President, Lieutenant Colonel Hugo Chavez, for a few minutes. We Venezuelans have to listen to him for an average of 3.5 hours every day for the past 5 years. We cannot change channels because old channels have to broadcast simultaneously when he is on the air. 3.5 hours for 5 years. As you can see, everyone who disagrees with President Chavez is an enemy, is a criminal, is a poisoner. He has called my employer, RCTV, a coup plotter, yet he has never charged me or any of my colleagues in a court of law. He can't, because we have nothing to hide. I have done nothing wrong but express my opinions. I accept that I do not agree with his government or his policies. And this is a crime in Venezuela as it is in Cuba and in other dictatorships. But I'm not alone. President Chavez calls a lot of people coup plotters. For instance, the King of Spain he calls a coup plotter. Also, the former Prime Minister of Spain he calls a coup plotter. How many people here have used Facebook or Twitter? Good, good. Mr. Chavez says Facebook and Twitter are also coup plotters. Mr. Chavez says Twitter is a tool for terrorists. He's not alone in hating Twitter. You may remember that Iran's student revolution was also criminalized for its use of Twitter. So it is not surprising that the president of Iran, who orders the killing of students, the hanging of gays, the torture of dissidents, is one of Chavez's best friends. He calls for internet controls. He calls everyone who has the opportunity to tell the truth someone who's trying to overthrow his regime. But who is the real coup plotter and the only one in 40 years to do this? He is. In 1992, Hugo Chavez tried and failed to kill the president, the democratically elected president of Venezuela. He was sent to prison for this crime. More than 100 people were killed when he tried and failed to overthrow the democratic government of Venezuela. That is, this is, I'll show you now, what Mr. Chavez has to say about my employer, RCTV. And please remember that some people say that the concession of the television expired, that it was a normal legal process. Well, I'll tell you, it wasn't. It was an order given by Lieutenant Colonel Hugo Chavez. Let's see what he has to say.
Se acaba la concesión. Ya está redactado la medida, así que vayan preparándose, apagando los equipos, pues. No se va a tolerar aquí ningún medio de comunicación que esté al servicio del golpismo contra el pueblo, contra la nación, contra la independencia nacional, contra la dignidad de la República. ¡Venezuela te respeta!
Siguen, pataleen, hagan lo que hagan, se acabó la concesión a ese canal fascista de RCTV. Hagan lo que hagan y digan lo que digan. Llámenme como quieran. No me importa.
On several occasions we have been attacked. Paramilitary groups identified with the government have thrown bombs at my personal home on two occasions, and I have been personally threatened to death by one of those paramilitary groups. In one case, a burning truck was sent against the entrance of our main office building. On that day, there were more than 1,500 employees inside the building. It was very dangerous. Remember, Lieutenant Colonel Chavez has tanks, destroyers, guns, jet fighters, attack helicopters, sniper rifles, submarines, all bought from Russia or Belarus. Thousands of millions of dollars. We have, on our side, we have cameras, reporters, faxes, and email. That is all. Our only weapon are our ideas. But we have a lot of support. Thousands of people marched for RCTV, students like you, especially, but the government did not like this, and they used their power against them. We have received the support of thousands of newspapers, radio and television stations across the world. This includes Amnesty International, Freedom House, Human Rights Watch, the Committee to Protect Journalists, the Global Coordinating Committee of Press Freedom Organizations, the Inter-American Society for Press, the Global Network for Free Media, the World Press Freedom Committee, the World Association of Newspapers and Newspapers Publishers, the International Federation of the Periodical Press, the CPU Media Trust, the International Association of Broadcasting. This association includes over 17,000 broadcasters all over the world, and literally thousands of newspapers, radio, and TV stations from across the world have condemned Chavez's government for its persecution of RCTV. I deem necessary, in order to avoid useless surprises in the future, and so that Venezuelans can raise our voices while there is still an opportunity to do it, I'm here to provide a warning. One day soon, all protest in Venezuela will be silenced, all dissidents, all political dissent, all opinions, all unions, all civil society, professional associations, popular associations that pretend to preserve a minimum of independence from the absolute power of the military regime will be eliminated. From that point on, there will be no political prisoners as those we have today in worrisome numbers, but we will have instead disappeared people, as in the tragic experience of other military dictatorships in Argentina, Chile, or Iran. I hope the people of Norway, the independent media around the world, and the international community in 10, 20, or 30 years will never have to say, we did not know who we were dealing with. I mean, who would have thought of this? Or perhaps something more diplomatic. We did suspect it, but there was so little information. Today in Venezuela, there is no separation of power. There are no independent judiciary power or legislative power or electoral power. There is no rule of law. Human rights and human dignity are not respected. Thus, the regime is neither legitimate, nor do we live in a democracy, nor they can justify their misdoings. Lieutenant Colonel Chavez should act as the president of all Venezuelans as he was elected, and not as the leader of one faction of the country. He publicly threatens the majority of Venezuelans by pronouncing every day this dreadful slogan, "Fatherland, socialism, or death." In schools, as you can see here, or in factories, or in every possible place. This is a public threat, notorious, and addressed to the majority of Venezuelans that reject his project. We do not rely much on international support. The Cuban experience, as Armando Valladares explained very clearly to us, may produce new and extemporaneous regrets, even when the repressive nature of the Cuban regime is not new to anyone. Cuba keeps silencing people, and lies are the official truth, just as they want to do in Venezuela. He silenced our television channel from the air, so we created a new channel, a channel on cable and satellite. It became number one within 1 month of being in the air. So several months ago, his government manipulated the cable and satellite providers and ordered them to take us off the air without any judicial sentence, without any official procedure. I ask all of you here, all of those watching, it is important that we keep in mind Elie Wiesel's wise warning. Indifference is never an option. Indifference is never an option. You have been officially warned. Thank you very much. Yeah.